50 billion. Say what you want, 50 billion.
Oh,
50 billion. Say what you call poverty. Say what you call poverty. Poverty.
Yes, 469 people. 150 billion naira. I will do a calculation for you here. Greatest Nigerians, 469 people. If you divide 150 billion by 469, that's 390 million per person. Hold on, I will explain it. 150 billion naira divided by 469 legislators gives you 390 million naira per person. Hold on, this here. The capital expenditure for Nigeria is 1.6 trillion naira. They've not spent it. They spent 850 billion. Now, divide 850 billion naira by 160 million Nigerians. Your worth per person is 5,312 naira. I will explain to you again. Our police officer here. Our civil society is there. You Nigerians, aside them who are 469, civil defense people, when we divide 850 billion naira that they have spent on bettering our lives, on tarring the roads, on giving us water, it will give you 5,000 naira, 312 naira. For one Nigerian, for you, for everyone. Whereas each member of our House of Assembly earns 319 million. Since they've not given us an explanation, we could give them that explanation. Because if you divide 150 billion by 469, it gives you that. Now, let us put it in perspective.
He knows this. You see, we've said it before. We are not violent. We are peaceful Nigerians. But we will remain undefiant. We will remain undivided. We will stand our ground to make our protest known, because every right that belongs to them belongs to us. We send them there to represent us. Are they representing us?
No!
In how many years
that we will have our House of Assembly members? How many of them have passed the bill? How many of them come to the House of Assembly to speak? Some of them sleep off. Some of them doze off. So Nigerians, will you be frustrated by these people?
No.
469 people, will you be frustrated by them?
No.
The future of this nation is in your hands. And because you are gathered here today, and tomorrow, and next, and when we call you out here together, we will save our nation from these leaders, and we will return it back to the heights that it deserves to be. Thank you very much.
How much have they been paid? We all know how much they have been paid. There are no industries in this country. The other women in the street, you call them criminals. They try to humble themselves through life to go get taken after riding, and you can't kill them in the middle of the night. And you're telling us that no, we shouldn't come here to protest. We are here because we want the institutions to be open. We are here because we want the government issue to end. We are here because we want corruption to give us way. We are here because we need industries to employ us. We are here because we need peace in this country. For God's sake, what is happening? What is happening? We are sending our brothers in uniform to come and work to harass us. These are people we know. I have brothers in military and everything. So please, we are making a mistake. The security men should know you are here for us. You are not here to harass us. You are not here to attack us. We will not take that. If it comes to us, we can face ourselves. This is wrong. Nigerian youth, wake up. Please go viral on social media. Let everybody come down here. Tell them the likes of IG Rala are here, the likes of Abdul Majid are here, and more are coming. Everybody is coming down here. Let us take our destiny in our hands. Thank you very much.
Greatest Nigerians! Greatest Bobo! Greatest Baba! Greatest Shu!
My name is Shun Fakwadi. I want to say something here. Please, I need your hands. When I sing a song, you say Otoro. Say no to suffering! Suffering!
Ojo
safari.
Ojo
safari.
Ojo.
Say no to 150 billion.
Ojo.
150 billion.
Ojo.
Say no to 150 billion.
Ojo.
150 billion.
Ojo.
Say no to poverty.
Ojo.
Poverty.
Ojo.
Say no to poverty.
Ojo.
Nigerians 469 people 150 billion naira. I will do a calculation for you here. Greatest Nigerians, 469 people. If you divide 150 billion by 469, that's 319 million per person. Hold on, I will explain it. 150 billion naira divided by 469 legislators gives you 319 million naira per person. Hold on, this year, the capital expenditure for Nigeria is 1.6 trillion naira. They've not spent it. They spent 850 billion. Now, divide 850 billion naira by 160 million Nigerians. Your worth per person is 5,312 naira. I will explain to you again. Our police officer here. Our civil society is there. You Nigerians, aside them who are 469, civil defense people, when we divide 850 billion naira that they have spent on bettering our lives, on tarring the roads, on giving us water, it will give you 5,000 naira, 312 naira. For one Nigerian, for you, for everyone. Whereas each member of our House of Assembly earns 319 million. Since they've not given us an explanation, we could give them that explanation. Because if you divide 150 billion by 469, it gives you that. Now, let us put it in perspective. Every month in this country, $1 billion is being stolen from our health debt. That money alone, if you use that money into the health sector, you construct nothing less than 80 hospitals. And I will give you reasons why. In Jabi, Chinese government constructed an hospital for us for $12.4 million. Now, yes, because we don't have it. That's 1.4 billion naira. Now look at this. We are using 167 billion a month. If our government was serious, if the National Assembly were not distracted, if they were not playing party politics with our nation, they would have focused on that and used that money to build our roads, to send our children to school. ASUU has been on strike for how many days?
3 months.
For how many days?
3 months.
How much is ASUU asking for? 87 billion naira. That's how much they're asking for. Let me give you another perspective. We go every day on our street, Lagos, Abuja, Sokoto, Kaduna, anywhere. You will see our children on the street hawking pure water. Should that be? Should that be? Let me ask you another question. How many heads do our leaders have that we don't have? Why do we deserve to be treated as paupers, as peasants, as slaves by our own people? This is modern slavery. There's no other name to give to it. Let me give another perspective. In our security, how much do we spend every year? How much are we spending this year? So only be how much are we spending this year? 4.9 trillion. That's how much we're spending. What has changed? Are we safe?
No.
Are our brothers safe in Apo?
No.
Are they safe in Kaduna?
No.
Are they safe in Borno?
No.
Are they not Nigerians? Let me talk to our police officer. Tell them, don't they deserve better? Don't you deserve better? They can tell you in confidence. Part of them are here. SSS are here. They know how much they get paid every month. Are you satisfied with it?
No.
Our flesh and blood are earning 319 million per year. Why must we be subjected to wars in our own nations? In our own nation. Is it a crime to be a Nigerian? Is it a crime to be a Nigerian? Let me give you another shot up. Yesterday, I read the report. UNESCO released the report and said that in education spending by GDP, Nigeria came
136 out of 136. We are spending 0.89% of our GDP on education. Is this how we build a strong and viral nation? Is this how we build a great nation? Let me give you something here to take home. If Nigerians, young people, old people are not concerned, we'll be in trouble. The United Nations estimate that in 2050, we'll be 400 million citizens of Nigeria with no infrastructure, with no power, with no health services, with no insurance. What is the hope of the Nigerian if we don't march out to protest and tell our leaders we have had enough? Enough is
enough.
Enough is
enough.
You see, we've said it before. We are not violent. We are peaceful Nigerians. But we will remain undefiant. We will remain undivided. We will stand our ground to make our protest known, because every right that belongs to them belongs to us. We send them there to represent us. Are they representing us?
No!
In how many years that we have our House of Assembly members? How many of them have passed the bill? How many of them come to the House of Assembly to speak? Some of them sleep off. Some of them doze off. So Nigerians, will you be frustrated by these people?
No!
469 people, will you be frustrated by God?
No!
The future of this nation is in your hands. And because you are gathered here today, and tomorrow, and next, and when we call you out here together, we will save our nation from these leaders, and we will return it back to the heights that it deserves to be. Thank you very much.
None of them is doing the right thing. None of them is doing the right thing. We know the senators are not doing the right thing. How much are they being paid? How much are they being paid? We all know how much they are being paid. There are no industries in this country. The only thing in the street, you call them criminals. They try to humble themselves through life to go get taken after riding, and you go and kill them in the middle of the night. And you're telling us that no, we shouldn't come here to protest. We are here because we want the institutions to be open. We are here because we want the Boko Haram issue to end. We are here because we want corruption to give us way. We are here because we need industries to employ us. We are here because we need peace in this country. For God's sake, what is happening? What is happening?
Nigerian youth, wake up, please go viral on social media. Invite everybody, let everybody come down here. Let everybody come down here. Tell them the likes of Ajirola are here, the likes of Abdulmateen are here, and more are coming. Everybody is coming down here. Let us take our destiny in our hands. Thank you very much.
The capital expenditure for Nigeria is 1.6 trillion naira. They've not spent it, they spent 850 billion. Now, divide 850 billion naira by 160 million Nigerians. Your worth per person is 5,312 naira. I will explain to you again. Our police officer here. Our civil society is there. You Nigerians, aside them who are 469, civil defense people, when we divide 850 billion naira that they have spent on bettering our lives, on tarring the roads, on giving us water, it will give you 5,000 naira, 312 naira. For one Nigerian, for you, for me, for you, for everyone. Whereas each member of our House of Assembly earns 319 million. Since they've not given us an explanation, we could give them that explanation. Because